Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Suri Vaibhav and Irina Bulmaga. This is a game from the Gibraltar Masters 2020. Player with the white pieces in this game, Suri Vaibhav, is 22 years old, Indian chess star. And player with the black pieces, Irina Bulmaga, is Moldovan women's champion. Suri Vaibhav had white pieces and he started with e4. Irina Bulmaga played e5, knight to f3, knight to c6, bishop to c4, the Italian game, bishop to c5, c3, knight to f6, white to move. d4 is the most played move. The move dates back to Greco, who would demolish all his opposition with d4. But the move played in the game is the second most played move and is very fine move. It is d3, d6, bishop to g5, h6, bishop to h4, bishop to g4. If g5, bishop to g3, and black would be advised to avoid castling kingside. Back to our game. Bishop to g4, pinning the knight, asking a question. Bishop to e6, knight from b to d2, a5, if bishop takes on c4, knight takes on c4, a5, bishop to b5, pinning, bishop to d7 and pinning, and Suri Vaibhav castled kingside, black to move, since black didn't castle, g5, and pinning that way, bishop to g3, knight to h5, bishop to h2, knight to f4. It is true, the black knight is well placed. White to move. How would you continue? What is the best move for white in this position? Well, since black didn't castle, it makes sense to open the game, doesn't it? So, Suri Vaibhav played the move that is asking to be played, d4. Bishop to a7, white to move. How would you continue now? Suri Vaibhav spotted that the knight on c6 is a good defender of the pawn on e5, so he captured the defender of the pawn. B takes on c6. The other way to go was bishop to c6, and after d takes on e5, d5. White is still slightly better. Back to our game. We have b takes on c6, d takes on e5, d5. If d takes on e5, then knight takes on e5. d5, knight to d4, black to move. Bishop takes on d4 was played. If castling, then knight to f5. So we have bishop takes on d4, c takes on d4, knight to e6. If something like rook to b8, then bishop takes on f4, and after pawn takes bishop. E takes on d5, c takes on d5, the simplest way to continue is b3. White is better. Back to our game. Knight to e6 was played. White to move. How to defend the pawn on d4? What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Suri Vaibhav played knight to b1, defending the pawn on d4 with the queen, and intending knight to c3, putting the pressure on the pawn on d5. It is quite an amusing move and not easy to guess. Do you agree? f4 would be the sharpest reply. If the knight takes pawn on d4, then f5. White is better. Back to our game. Knight to b1. a4. Knight to c3. Rook to a5. Queen to d2. Queen to a8. f4. This move was asking to be played. G takes on f4. Bishop takes on f4. Threatening bishop takes pawn on h6. h5. Bishop to g5. Not afraid of the knight. Rook to g8, removing the target. Queen to a7, intending queen takes pawn on d4. Rook from a to d1. Knight to f8. White to move. What would you do? White played a move and black resigned, and the move is queen to f4. Irina Bulmaga resigned. If rook to g7, then queen to f6 with a double attack. And after a random move, queen to d8, check, mate. And let's go back. F5 would prolong the suffering. One line goes like this. Pawn takes pawn on f5. C5, queen to h6, c takes on d4. Queen to f6, d takes on c3, check, king to h1. Queen to c5, defending e7 square. E6, threatening queen to f7, check, mate. After bishop takes on e6, pawn takes bishop, knight takes on e6, queen to f7, check, mate. That was quite a lovely Italian game, wasn't it? What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.